Dear students, welcome to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe my channel to watch all videos on 10th Science CBSE. Before this, in my previous video, we can learn that is image formation by convex lens and ray diagrams. Ray diagrams of formation of image by a convex lens. In last video, we can study the three diagrams. And in that particular three diagram, you are given a position of object. Then we can draw the diagram, ray diagram, and indicate that position of image, the nature of image, and also the size of image. Dear student, you can draw the diagram, you can make the practice of this diagram by using the geometry box. We will study the next three diagrams now in this video lecture or today. Look here. You are given a position of that object here, and we can draw the diagram of image formation there by convex lens. Look here, there is a number 4 diagram. We are given a position of object between f1 and 2f1, object between f1 and 2f1. Look here, then where is the image? We can draw the diagram. Here you know there is convex lens, here optical center O, then you know there is a principal axis, here f2, then 2f2, here f1 and 2f1. Where is object? Object between f1 and 2f1. Here is a object here, that AB is object. Dear student, we can use the two rules, that is rule number 1 and rule number 3. What is rule number 1? That light ray parallel to principal axis, refracted ray passes from focus. Rule number 1. We can use here rule number 1. Light ray parallel to principal axis, then refracted ray passes from focus. In this way, we can use the rule number 1. Then here in this diagram, we can use the rule number 3. Which is the rule number 3? That is, light ray passes from optical center O. It passes undeviated in this way. Light ray passes from optical center O. It passes undeviated. Both the refracted ray meet behind the 2F2. And here is the image of object. Object A dash B dash is an image of object. Means in this way, there is object between F1 and 2F1. Where is image? Image behind 2F2. Image behind 2F2 means here image behind 2F2. Image behind 2F2 means here is the diagram. What is the nature of image? That is real and inverted. Nature of image, real and inverted. It is below the principal axis and just the right side of the lens. Hence, that nature of image is real and inverted. Then you know what is size of image. Size, that is a bigger than object, or we call magnified image. Magnified image means it is a bigger than object, it is the size is larger than object. Means that is the ray diagram number 4. Object between f1 and 2f1, image behind 2f2. Nature real and inverted, size magnified image. That is diagram number 4. Dear student, what is diagram number 5? How we discuss the diagram number 5? that object at focus, no, object at focus, object at F1 means at a focus, and union object at focus definitely image as infinity. We can draw the diagram here. There is a convex lens, convex lens. Here optical center O. How we draw the diagram when object at F1? Then you know here a principal axis. Here F2 and 2F2. Here F1 and 2F1. Dear student, object at focus in this way. That is AB is object at F1, object at focus. Then here also we use the first and third rule. First rule is there that light ray parallel to principal axis, then refracted ray gets passes from focus. Refracted ray gets passes from focus. Light ray parallel to principal axis, refracted ray passes from focus. Rule number one. Then what is rule number three? That light ray passes from optical center means image at infinity, that both the refracted ray not meet at a single point, just they can meet at every point, or just, you know, at a very long point means in this way, but now they are parallel to each other means, you know, here image at infinity, there is no any fixed position of the image, hence we call image at infinity. Dear student, here we can study the first diagram. When object at infinity, image at focus in first diagram in last video, but here in this diagram, in fifth diagram, object at focus, image at infinity means image at infinity, image at infinity, object at F1, image at infinity. Then nature of image, nature that is real and inverted, nature real and inverted, and size highly magnified, highly magnified image means a very very large image, very very big image means in this way, that is a diagram number 5. Then last diagram there, dear student, in this 5 diagram there is the same nature of image, that is real and inverted, but in the last diagram when object between F1 and optical center O, then here change the nature of image. That is in last diagram when object between F1 and optical center, that image is virtual and erect to same side of the object. Means in this way, your diagram number 6, that is object between F1 and O, object between F1 and O, here you know convex lens, here optical center O, then principal axis, here F2, then 2F2, here F1 and 2F1. There is one object between F1 and 2F1 in this way. AB is object. Here also use the first and third rule. First rule is the light ray parallel to principal axis, refracted ray gets passes from focus. Rule number one. Second rule here, light ray passes from optical center in this way, it passes undivided. Imagine here that both the light rays comes from the single point on the same side of the object, and there is the position of image, and that is called, we indicate a dotted line here, because that is not a real image, it is the virtual image, and just here it is above the principal axis, hence here a dash b dash is image. Means in this way, here nature of image is virtual and direct, not the real image. Here it is the virtual image. Means in this way, object between F1 and O, image same side of object, image same side of object, then what is nature of image here? Nature in this way, nature virtual and erect, virtual and erect, and size here, size magnified image, size magnified image means it is a bigger than object, or size of image is larger than object. Means dear student, in this way we can complete this topic of image formation by convex lens. We can study the three rules to form the image of object by using the convex lens. Then by using all these three rules, we can draw the six ray diagram by using the convex lens. In all this diagram, you are given a position of object, and after this, in question paper also, you are given a position of object, and from this position of object, we can draw the diagram, and after drawing the diagram, we indicate the position of image there, then nature of image and size of image. Dear student, you can make a practice very well. You can make some hard work very well, and you know it is necessary to understand the topic carefully, and in this way you can totally draw the all diagrams very easily. If the topic is not understandable, then you are unable to draw the diagram easily. Dear student, if that any doubt in this topic, then ask to me at any time. I will just solve your total problems. Hence, in this way, here there is ray diagrams of convex lens. There is image formation by convex lens, and in this way, here we complete this topic of that image formation by convex lens. In my next video, I am starting a new topic here. That is image formation by concave lens. That image of object formed by concave lens. Hence, it is necessary to watch my another next video also to understand the topic, that is image formation by concave lens. The rules which are used to draw the image of object by concave lens, and also the ray diagram of concave lens, and this total chapter. In this way, here to watch the previous videos, and also to watch the another videos, coming videos there, and please subscribe my channel, YouTube channel, to learn a total syllabus of science, the 10th class CBSE, that is physics, chemistry and biology. Very, very thanks.